everybody, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. Reaction is going to be for someone I haven't done it in a while, and also it's a collab with somebody that I have never reacted to before. I've seen a lot of other reactors that pop up on my YouTube reacting to this guy, and he's what I'd never heard of until I saw these reactions coming up. I've never actually watched any of these reactors' videos yet because I thought, well, there's so many of these reactions coming up that he's obviously something pretty good. So I wanted to sort of hold off and react to him myself. It's Tom MacDonald and Dax, and it's a collab for a song called Propaganda, and this is their official music video for it. It's just recently been released, not too long ago. So I thought, okay, a new artist in collab with, or a new artist to me, in collab with an artist that I absolutely love and I admire and I respect and I've reacted to in the past a number of times. It's a perfect collab, surely. It's got to be a perfect collab. I'm obviously going to be in for a treat. So without further ado, let's get into the video. Here we go. I'm actually really quite excited about this because it's Dax and he always, as far as I'm concerned, he always delivers. He's always quite controversial and brilliant at what he does. And like I say, it's a new artist, Tom MacDonald. So this will be interesting. It's a first time reaction for him. So let's see what he's got. Here we go. Our own truth isn't always the reality. That's very true, hey, actually.
You good, bro? Ain't picking up calls, dog. What's wrong, man? Daryl, you good? Hey. Hey, Daryl.
And whites and lefts and rights to stop the madness. They planned it. It's Trump or Biden. We all been divided, riot in the streets. Elections always been rigged. I ain't surprised when somebody cheats. All I see is pentagrams and the propaganda, but our priority's the vaccine. It ain't hard for wolves to find.
Okay, I'm assuming that's Tom MacDonald. I saw him just right at the beginning of the video, and I just assumed maybe that was an actor guy. But now I'm obviously he's rapping, and yeah, I'm assuming that's Tom MacDonald. Okay, well, first impressions of this, I'm loving the video, the whole concept about people kind of just fixated on the television screens and filming everything and stuff. Just the whole propaganda thing is you just get fed and bombarded over and over again by media and just other people's ideals and opinions and conspiracies and things like that. And eventually, sometimes you can just get bogged down with it to the point that you end up believing stuff that you never ever would have thought you'd believe in. And that is, yeah, it's classic propaganda. So I'm loving the way, yeah, he's sort of making a point about that. It's kind of you just get bombarded, you get brainwashed. Literally, it's brainwashing. Yeah, I love the visuals of it, and yeah, poor Dax getting rained on again, always out in his vest or topless or whatever. I don't think he owns a coat. We should save up and get him one, or the Dax fans should save up and send him a coat. Bless him. I'm kidding. Yeah, I love it so far. I'm interested to see what Tom MacDonald delivers. I know he's just started, and I'm going to go back a little bit on his bit and just listen to him again. But yeah, so far it's really, really interesting. I like the concept for it. Okay, I'm going to go back and let's see what's what. Okay. Love him singing that.
They convinced us all that everything we say is racist. Then blood will change it, that's what happens. Y'all need balance. Y'all need blacks and whites and lefts and rights to stop the madness. They planned it. It's Trump or Biden, we all been divided by it in the streets. Elections have always been rigged. I ain't surprised when somebody cheats. All I see is pentagrams and the propaganda, but our priority's the vaccine. It ain't hard for wolves to find a flock when the sheep are fast asleep. Too many people lack character. Too many journalists scaring you. Too many pencils attempting to rewrite the Constitution. They probably gonna tear it up. I love the country, but I don't trust the people taking care of us. We went to bed with the American dream. We woke up in Nightmerica.
Oh my God, that's incredible. Oh, I'm going to have to go back on that one and just listen to that bit again. Oh, the American dream. Just how he said we went to bed with the American dream and we woke up in Nightmerica. Not America. Nightmerica. Oh my God, the play on words. That is genius, genius. And also I love what he said about how it's not hard for the wolves to find the flock when the sheep are fast asleep. So it's kind of the people that are in charge, the people that are at the top and that have the biggest influence, they prey on the people that are below them, the people that are down here, you and me. The public, the likes of us. I love that. The play on words, that is insane. Now, I don't know whether they wrote their individual bits or whether they kind of put it all together and then decided on who was going to rap what. I don't know how they went about doing this. It'd be interesting. I'd love to actually ask them, how did you come up with, you know, who was going to say what lyrics? Did you write your own pieces? But wow. That's impressive. I love that. That's Tom MacDonald already is impressing me, because if he wrote that, even if they both wrote it together and then just decided who was going to say what, if he wrote that, that is genius. That the play on words lyrically, that is perfection. That is so, so clever. And he's already impressing me for that. As I said, this is the first reaction I've done of Tom MacDonald, so there's a lot more out there that I know there is, because like I say, I've seen loads of reactors reacting to his stuff, and this is making me definitely want to start reacting to his, because he just, that was on point. Everything he just said was on point. I'm just going to go back a little bit on that just to hear that again, because that was perfection, the way he worded that. That was awesome. I loved that.
The propaganda, but our priority's the vaccine. It ain't hard for wolves to find a flock when the sheep are fast asleep. Too many people lack character. Too many journalists scaring you. Too many pencils attempting to rewrite the Constitution. They probably gonna tear it up. I love the country, but I don't trust the people taking care of us. We went to bed with the American dream. We woke up in Nightmerica.
Oh. And can I also just say, from somebody who, I don't mean any disrespect when I'm kind of saying that everything is on point that he's saying, but and it seems like I'm agreeing with everything that he says, as if America is a bad place. There is good and bad in every single country in this world. And I'm over in the UK, I'm not in America, so I'm not an American citizen. So some people would actually argue, well, you have no right to trash, you know, another country when you don't even live there and you don't really understand what's going on. From what I see, that I'm only basing my opinions and my reactions on things that I'm hearing and what I've seen. And I totally get why he would say, and it's the same with anywhere, can you really trust, when he made the point about, can you really trust the people that are in charge? Are they really trustworthy? The people that give you promises, but then they never deliver on them. And they've got a history of that, just as a whole, not just even individual people, just as a whole. they make promises but they don't often deliver. I just wanted to make that point that I'm not trashing America, I'm not trashing anybody's country at all. But yeah, I totally understand. I totally get where he's coming from, where he said you went to bed with the American dream, because the idea of America is a dream. It's why so many people move there. It's why so many people look up to America and admire it. And in many ways, it is great. But unfortunately, there is bad in America and everywhere over here. Crikey, there's so much bad over here, as well as a lot of good. But it's not the American dream that it's cracked up to be. It's not a dream, it's a nightmare sometimes. So I love that he said that, but I just wanted to say, I'm not trashing America, I'm not trashing anybody's country. I'm just agreeing with the fact that there's good and bad everywhere in any country in the world. I just wanted to point that out before he carries on. Please don't come at me. Okay, so let's carry on. And all I see is propaganda. Love Dirk singing. Visually, it's brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Wow. Okay, that kind of seemed really short. I was like, oh, whoa, is it finished already? wow. I mean, there's so much going on in that video, visually, but and vocally, but it just, yeah, seemed to just suddenly go past really quick. I thought there might be like another verse or something, but yeah, like I say, just on point with everything that they're saying. It's there are a lot of things that you question whether you can actually trust the people and the events and the way they broadcast it to the world and the way they feed into a whole fear of people and just how they change somebody's mindset, how easy it is to brainwash a few people, and then that brainwashing spreads and that propaganda spreads and it just filters down, just does its job, and before you know it, everyone's living in fear. And yes, don't get me wrong, there is a lot to fear in this world, sadly, that is true, but a lot of it is scaremongering as well. At the same time, it's a lot of propaganda, it's a lot of false narratives and just bad, false things that are going around out there. Media can be a good thing for exposing things that need to be exposed and, you know, letting someone's voice be heard and getting things seen, but at the same time it does cause a lot of damage and devastation, and it's not always a great thing. And I think we all have to be very, very careful what we feed into and what we believe, because it's not always as it seems. It can be spun a completely different way to what it actually is. And as it said at the beginning of there, our truth is not always the truth. It can be false if we feed into the wrong things and we believe the wrong things and get too caught up in it. So I think you've just got to try and keep an open mind and sort of a level head, not get caught up too much in all the craziness of the world. Pay attention, but kind of look at it from totally different perspectives, lots of different perspectives. Think outside the box. Don't just get caught up in one particular viewpoint, and just be mindful of how you're thinking and how you're reacting to something and how you're looking at something, and analyze it, research it, you know, think for yourself. Don't follow everybody else and think that that's the right way to go because that person seems trustworthy or because they sound convincing. Sometimes it's not always the case, and a lot of these people, unfortunately, at the top and the people that put these things out there are very good liars. They have to be, because it's how they are successful in what they do. And, you know, obviously their strategy for brainwashing people and putting propaganda out there has worked. That's why they carry on doing what they do, because more and more people feed into it. It's a very deep subject to get into, and I don't want to get too far into it, but this is a reaction to the video and I'm just sort of giving my thoughts on it. But yeah, we just have to be very careful with what we buy into and what we pay attention to, and just think for yourself and not get too caught up in everything that's going on, I think, or it would just drive you nuts. Conspiracy theories and just mistrust in everything, and it just leads to so much craziness and very frightening things that end up happening. Anyway, I really, really enjoyed this video. I'm very impressed with Tom MacDonald, just things that he had to say in this video and his delivery on it. He looks like a pretty cool guy. I love the tattoos and the hair and the piercings and stuff. He's kind of outside the norm, which I love. I love people that are not afraid to kind of be themselves, to be different and not conform to society standards of what they should look like and be like and act like and things that they should and shouldn't say. Some people would say it's way too controversial, but that's one of the things that I love about Dax, is that he says it like it is, how he feels about things, what he thinks about things. And Tom MacDonald is obviously another one of those who clearly doesn't really care. He would just tell it like it is. He'll just tell it how he sees it. Two of those kind of controversial artists doing a collab together, that's brilliant. And I'd love to actually see them in the future do another collab, because I think they've got, between the two of them, they've got a lot to say, which makes a lot of sense. I love this video, and if you did too, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to keep up with more Dax reactions coming up. Hopefully there's lots more to react to of his past and sort of recent and future ones, I'm sure. And Tom MacDonald as well, who I'm going to be reacting to more and more very, very soon in the coming weeks and months. And I will see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye, guys.